Hey guys, good morning everyone. Today we are going to undergo an experiment of how to dissect an hibiscus flower. So before we enter into the dissection experiment, I want to tell you about the parts of this hibiscus. So before that, see, this is a bud of an hibiscus flower. So it has not yet bloomed. And the greener part which is holding this petals is called as sepals. The other name for these sepals is called as calyx. And this is the leaf of the hibiscus flower. Okay. So, I'll tell you about the parts now properly. So, as I said, this the greener part is called as sepals, or else it is called as calyx, and the petals, the bright red petals, is also called as corolla. And here you can see a yellow like dots, which is called as an anther, which is stick to this style through an filament. You can see a very very thin capillary like structures which is attached to the gynoecium of this flower. Okay, so and the yellow part is the anther, and it is connected to this style using the filament. So the upper part is called stigma, this longer tube is called as style. So let me tell you what are the things necessary or what are the things required for the dissection of this hibiscus flower. The main things we used to need is just an hibiscus flower and a blade, a sharp blade or a sharp small knife. These two things alone are needed for the dissection of the hibiscus flower. So students, please don't do this individually. Accompany your parents and do these experiment under the surveillance of your parents. Why? Because you are using the blade. So be careful, and if you don't know how to do this, please have the help of your parents. So let's start about the dissection of the hibiscus flower now. So I'll tell you the step by step how to dissect a flower first. So turn a flower like this. All you need to do is you have to first peel off the calyx. First you have to. So before that, I want to tell you, we have to handle the flowers, not only this hibiscus but all the flowers, in a soft and smooth manner. Okay, so first of all you have to remove the calyx part. So be careful. So a small mistake may damage everything. So be careful and be patient while you are doing this. So see here, I have removed the calyx part. So there is no calyx here, that is, there is no sepal here. And next is, you have to hold this tightly and the down here, and you have to remove each and every petal slowly. Slowly you have to remove the petals. So see, these are the petals. Slowly you have to remove the petals. Be careful, remove off the petals gradually. Yes, fine. See now, you can see now only the male and female part of this hibiscus flower. So this long tube-like structure is the gynoecium, and at the side you can find yellow-like pollen grains, that is anther, which is sticked to this style, that is which is sticked to this gynoecium through a filament. So this side things are called as stamens, and this together is called as gynoecium. So let me peel off all this androecium. I'll show you later. So the yellow color thing is called as the pollen grains. So pollination occurs only through this pollen grains. I felt that this will be a better thing for you people to understand this thing completely. So see, I have removed all the male part, that is anther which is sticked to the filament. See some insects. See, as soon as I stretched it down, the ant is coming for the pollen grains. It is attracted by the pollen grains. See, the ant is coming so that it starts to take a job of pollination here. So see here, only the female part is left over here. So this is stigma, style, and this part is the ovary. This is where the pollination takes place. So the pollen grains from the anther and filament, and from the anther, is transferred here through this part and goes inside here, and then the pollination takes place. So now I want to show you how to see the ovary, which is inside this long tube. So this is a very very careful statement. Why? Because this is very very delicate. This is a very very delicate thing. So be careful. So a wrong, the tube will be very very thin. So be careful while you cut this. So don't cut fully, that is please don't pierce it till the ground, just scratch only the top layer of this. Okay, see, start from here, just only the top layer alone. Inside this there will be a very very fine thin tube. Even I done this video after a small mistake. So please do this very carefully, and you should have such patience to do this. Fine. So see, I have drawn some mark here. See, so that I can open this here. Wait a minute. See, it has got collapsed. So, okay, anyhow, I want to show you the ovary. I want to show you the ovary here. So, since it is like piscous, it really slips my finger here. Okay, so can you see the greener part here? Wait a minute. So this is the ovary. Inside this you have the ovule. Okay, so from here, see here, from here, from the stigma, the pollen grains enter into this ovule through a very 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 minute and very very thin tube like structure, and here in this ovary the pollination occurs. So this is how we have to dissect an hibiscus flower. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Thank you.